Appeals has weighed in on the situation with a new ruling. The justices reversed a lower court decision that would have prevented, the state and city from executing a consent agreement or some other option by Monday's looming deadline.
And while most of the talk has been about a consent agreement, an emergency manager remains an option. 7X News reporter Kim Russell joins us live now from Detroit. So, Kim, what happens now?
Well, we're told that city council members will be meeting here at City Hall all week and trying to come up with a plan to address this financial crisis. In the meantime, we don't know who will be leading the city next month. Will the governor take power from Detroit leaders due to the city's severe financial emergency? And if so, will an emergency manager be put in charge or a financial advisory board as called for in the consent agreement proposed by Governor Rick Snyder and his financial review team? 7 Action News legal analyst Tom Kramer says anything is possible now that the Michigan Court of Appeals ruled a state review team can move forward on that consent agreement.
The Court of Appeals has reversed the lower court and basically indicated that they can't interfere with the process.
The issue was before the court because an activist named Robert Davis sued, saying the agreement written up by the Detroit Financial Review Team was invalid because the team didn't comply with the Open Meetings Act. Although the team has been told to comply with that act, the court decided its work will not be thrown out.
I think it would properly be characterized as a victory for the state. It continues to keep the options open and allows the dialogue between the state and the city to continue.
The activist fighting the state says he's planning an appeal. The city as of now has a March 29th deadline to come up with a plan, or the governor's office is threatening to put an emergency manager in place. And city leaders are doing what they can to avoid the appointment of an emergency manager. Just yesterday, representatives from unions that represent thousands of city workers said that they came to a deal and accepted a 10% pay cut and other cuts that could save the city about $100 million. The question is, will what they've done so far and what they're going to be able to do in the coming days be enough? Live in Detroit, Kim Russell, 7 Action News. All right.